Yeah, so hi everyone. So today I'm going to give you my interview experience at IIT Jodhpur for PhD program in computer science and engineering. Okay, so firstly, you have to apply for PhD program on their official website of IIT Jodhpur. You can search it out on Google. You will find it easily. And then it's around 300 rupees cost for your application form. Okay. And afterwards, there are various rounds in your selection process. As far as my experience is there are two rounds, coding round and there is interview round. In coding round, there are 4 to 5 questions they ask in coding. Okay, like questions are like simple to average. Questions are like, we have to find XOR of two numbers, or we have to find the trailing zeros, trailing zeros of any number, right? So these are the kind of questions they ask in coding round. I don't think it's tough to clear coding round if you have a basic idea about coding. Okay, then main selection goes around interview round. Okay, and it goes for around 40 to 50 to 60 minute for me. Okay, now I will tell you what are the questions they ask mostly there in interview. Like one professor asked me, like I having interest in AML, so accordingly they asked me questions related to machine learning. Like they asked me to elaborate about your neural network, what are the things are there inside neural network, your SVM thing, like your spot vectors. Like in neural network, there are so many things you have to explain and all. Okay, like in neural network, you have softmax functions, you have a hidden layers, input layer, output layers. Okay, so all the things you have to explain there properly. Okay, like in SVM, we have a hyperplanes. We are classifying into two classes, right? Okay, there are spot vectors and all, and you have to explain them well. And then they ask me like questions related to, they give me one coding questions like how to find the median of array of numbers. Okay, so this is one question they asked me in interview. Okay, and then they ask me questions like elaborate what is algorithms. Okay, so you can give very simple answers like algorithm is nothing but it's a like step solution of any problem. Right, that is your algorithm. Whether you are working in a DP or whether you are working at trees, you are working at graphs, you are writing simple hello print program, that is also your algorithm, right? It's a step-by-step solution to any problem. Then another professor asked me related to my projects and publications. Like I did various projects. I can tell you some of them. Like I worked on plant disease identification using neural network. I worked on hyperspectral images where I did classification of various universal data sets. Okay, and one of more project I worked on brain tumor classification and detection using ensembling classifiers. Right. So professor, I know I also have a publications on that. So professor asked me related to my brain tumor classification thing. So they asked me in depth like what I did, how I did, and all. Like mostly I used in brain tumor, I used various things like the first is image collection, then we are segmenting those images using ORSU method. Okay, then we are doing feature extraction using your ideal threefold approach, like your PCA, your SWTs, stationary wavelet transforms, and GLCM methods, right? And afterwards, I did classification using hybrid ensemble classifiers. So they are asking questions in that, like in ORSU method, how you find the threshold value, what is threshold value? Like threshold value is your value below than that pixel is counted as a zero, above that it is counted as a one. Okay, so they ask me questions like how you find those threshold values, like whether it is manually taken as a hit and trial method, you are taking it randomly, or you are finding it through some methods and all. So for my case, I have taken it randomly, so I said that I have taken it randomly. Then, like in feature extractions, they tell me how the GLCM works internally. So I have a knowledge about that, how it works. So I tell them how it works, how we have to make matrices, and how we can extract it out from image matrices. We make a GLCM matrices and all. So I explain them those things. Okay. Then I was not well prepared for mathematics things like your vectors, your these things, your like in mathematics, like what is rank of a matrices, okay, and all things and all related stuff which we study in computer science branch. So I was not well prepared in maths, so I didn't perform well in maths, but still it went fine. He asked very normal questions like your trace of a matrices, we find eigen vector, eigen values, and all related questions they asked me. Okay, then there is one senior professor who asked me some questions. He gave me one these coding questions that find you have to swap two numbers without using temporary variables. Okay, you have to do these questions. So sometimes I was not able to do this thing. What solution is in my mind is using temporary variables. So I was not able to do this question as well. But it doesn't matter. And then he asked me why I want to join IIT Jodhpur. So like whenever they are asking you such kind of questions, now you have to give very good, you have to give some mindful answers like why we want to join any institution, why we want to join, when we will join any institution, because there are good labs are there, there are good faculty, okay, under whom you can work, there are all the facilities are there, where which are required in your PhD time. Okay, when you have all these things are there in any institution, only then you want to join that institution. So you have to give such kind of answers. That is what I did. And so okay, as there are also some professors from University of Virginia there for AEML, so I said all those things like there are good labs, there are professors from University of Virginia and all. Okay, so such kind of answers I have given to him. Then while you have when I have applied in PhD program, so they also given some Google forms in which you have to select your area of interest. So I select ML and artificial general intelligence. So one ma'am asked me questions, what do you understand by artificial general intelligence? So mostly AI we classify into two types, like artificial narrow intelligence and artificial general intelligence things. Okay, so like artificial narrow intelligence is your supervised and unsupervised learning, which we are working in nowadays. Nowadays we are mostly working on supervised learning, as there are also people are working on reinforcement learning as well. So as of now today, which we are working artificial narrow intelligence. So artificial general intelligence is your higher level, advanced level of AI, where you can mimic, you can make a robots which can mimic a human being. That is your artificial general intelligence, okay, at higher level, okay, of artificial intelligence. So such a kind the way you have to give these answers, and teacher really got impressed and all. Okay. So this is mostly a kind of experience I have. And like in starting, they will ask you about your introduction and all. You have to give it well as well. You have to give it properly. Like I am from NIT Kushetra. I have a good CGPA. I qualified my CSE branch with top 5 students in my college. Okay, so my introduction, my resume was quite good. Okay, that is also one of your plus point. Okay, so that is how this kind of interviews, these kind of questions are asked in PhD interviews. That is my experience at IIT Jodhpur. So you can see I also received one offer letter from IIT Jodhpur, but unfortunately I already have good job in MNC, so I haven't joined this. I haven't accepted this offer letter, but it was quite good experience to know what are the requirements in PhD and all, where I stand. You can also give these interviews not only when you wanted to be a PhD student or you want to join it. You can also give these interviews to see where you stand, what are the requirements in various, whether it's MS, whether it's PhD, to judge those, to understand those requirements. You can also give these kind of interviews.